Sairam children, welcome to maths class. Children, we have started with our chapter number 8, measurement. Correct? And measurement is divided into three parts: length, weight and capacity. So we have seen length and weight. Today we are going to understand the concept of capacity. Children, now what do we mean by capacity? Capacity mean volume, okay? That is the amount of liquid that a container can hold. Now we all know which are liquid substance, right? Like water, milk, then kerosene, petrol and other liquidy things, correct? So that liquid, when we put it in a container, so how much that container can hold is the capacity of the container. Now let us see few examples. See children, here we have a water tank, okay? Normally what do we store here? Water. Then we have bucket here. Then we have milk, correct? Milk is liquid. Then see children, here are different containers, okay, where we can store water or any other liquid. For example, juice, okay? You drink juice, watermelon juice, correct? So here you can see the first one, the container, it can hold 25 milliliter of liquid. The second one can hold 500 milliliter and the last one can hold 1 liter. Children, then we can see few more containers where water can be stored. Now I have told you about milliliter and liter. Now what are these? The standard units of measurement of capacity are liters and milliliters. Okay, like for how length we had centimeter, meter and kilometer, correct? Then for weight we had grams and kilograms, and for capacity it is measured in liters and milliliters. Okay, now for example, if you are going to a shop, you will not say that please give me 4 kg of milk. No, you can say 4 liters of milk, correct? Children, liters, that is L, is used for measuring larger capacities, and milliliters, that is ML, is used for measuring smaller capacities. Now this is the formula: 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Okay, liter is bigger and milliliter is smaller, correct? So we have, when we reach till 1000 milliliter, it will be equal to 1 liter. Okay, now remember this, it is very important. Children, now let us understand conversion of liters into milliliters. Now see, previously also, if we need to convert from a bigger unit to smaller unit, that time what do? We multiply by 1000, correct? Here also is the same case. If we need to convert from liters into milliliters, we have to multiply by 1000, okay? Here, for example, 2 liters. Now 2 liters, if we need to convert into milliliters, how we will do? We have to multiply by 1000, okay? 2 into 1000 milliliter is equal to 2000 milliliter. Then here we have one more example where we have 43 liter, okay? 43 liters, which is equal to 43 multiplied by 1000. So how many liters they have given, that we have to multiply by 1000 and we'll get our answer. 43 into 1000 is 43,000 milliliters. Understood, children? Now let us see a different sum where we have liters and milliliters together and we have to express it in milliliters. Now 3 liters and 250 milliliters we have to convert into milliliter. So children, here we can see in the question, we already have 250 milliliters. Okay, it is already in milliliter. So we will not touch it. The first thing is we are going to convert this 3 liter. Okay. as we know 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter, so 3 liter is equal to 3 multiplied by 1000 milliliter, correct? And 3 into 1000 is, yes, 3000 milliliter. Very good. Then let us write the question and we will substitute everything. What is 3 liters? 3000 milliliter plus, what is remaining here? 250 milliliter. Okay. So when we will add 3000 plus 250, we will get 3250 milliliter. Okay, children, this is how we are going to convert liters and milliliters into milliliter. See, children, here I have written the same thing how we have to convert. Okay, so children, next one is conversion of milliliters into liters. Now it is opposite. Okay, we have to convert a smaller unit into bigger unit. Okay, milliliters into liters. So what do? We have to divide by 1000. Okay, from bigger to smaller unit we multiply by 1000, and from smaller to bigger unit we divide by 1000. So look at this example. 4000 milliliter is equal to, okay, now first we will take this 4000 and then we will divide it with 1000, correct? You can cancel the zeros here, both the sides. You can divide and you will get the answer 4 divided by 1, which is equal to 4 liter. Okay. Now next one, we have here 16000 milliliter. Okay, we have to convert it into liters, which is equal to 16000 divided by 1000 liter. Let us cancel the zeros on both the sides. One zero cut here, then next, and then the last one. What do we get? 16 divided by 1, which is equal to 16 liters. Okay, children, let us see one more example where we have to convert 4125 milliliters into liters and milliliters. Okay, so our first step is to expand the number, and we are going to expand the number in thousands place. Okay, so 4125 milliliter is equal to 4000 milliliter plus 125 milliliter. Okay, we have expanded in thousands place, and 4 is there in thousands place, so it is 4000. Then we will take this 4000 milliliter and convert it into liter. Okay, we know how to convert. We have to divide by 1000, correct? So it is 4000 divided by 1000 liter. So after dividing, we will get 4 divided by 1, which is 4 liter. Now step 1 is complete, where we have converted 4000 milliliters into liters, correct? So let us write the expanded form here again. Okay, 4000 milliliter is equal to 4 liters. Okay, so I'm just replacing it. Then plus 125 milliliter, correct? So now we have got the answer actually, meters and milliliters, but here we have addition sign, so we are going to remove it. So final answer is 4 liters and 125 milliliters. Okay, children, see, children, the same thing. First we are going to expand the number, then we will convert 4000 milliliter into liter, okay, by dividing it by 1000. Then we will write the expanded form and we are going to replace the numbers. 4000 milliliter is equal to 4 liter plus 125 milliliter. We will remove the addition sign and we will get our answer. Okay? Children, now it's time for quick tip. Okay? Teacher will show you a shortcut method also. So here, like when we convert milliliter into liter and milliliter, okay, how we can do it directly. Now look at this example, 4028 milliliter. Okay, I want to write the answer in liter as well as in milliliter. So the last three digit always stands for milliliter. Okay, remember this. See, 4028 milliliter, so the last three digit, okay, which is in ones, tens and hundreds place, it is in milliliter, and then the other number it will be in liter. Okay, so you can write the answer directly also. It is 4 liter and 28 milliliter. See one more example, 5975 milliliter. Okay, so the last three digit is 975, correct? So if I want to write it in liters and milliliters, it will be 5 liters and 975 milliliters. Got it, children? So children, for today this much only. Thank you. Have a good day.